Hi, this is Bilal from Speckle. In this video, I want to show you how to go from Revit to Power BI and view your models in 3D inside Power BI. Let's start with the requirements. First and foremost, you need to have a Speckle account, and you can get one by going to speckle.xyz. It is completely free. It has no limitation, so you can give it a try and see the value. Next, since we are going to send data from Revit, you need to install the Speckles connector for Revit. And I already created a separate video on how to do that. There will be a pop-up in the top right corner of this video. Go there, watch the video, complete the steps, and come back. Next, we will receive data in Power BI. So you need to have the Power BI data connector installed as well. There will be another pop-up in the top right corner of this video. Watch the video, complete the steps, and come back. And finally, you also need to install the 3D Viewer visual for Power BI, which allows you to see your Speckle models, the models you send from Revit, Rhino, Grasshopper, any application we support in 3D inside Power BI. All right, so once you complete the steps, we can continue. In this video, I'm going to use the Revit's advanced sample project so you can easily follow me. So let's get started. First, we are going to enable the Speckle connector by going to Speckle tab and clicking on the Revit connector button. This will open this dialog where your projects are listed. You can either create a new project or use an existing one. In this case, I'm going to use this project, Power BI Tutorials. So inside a project, there can be multiple models, multiple branches. And you can either create a new one or use an existing model to send data to. I will create a new one by clicking on this drop-down menu, going to down and clicking on add new branch. So branches are basically models that can contain multiple versions of your model. So let's give this a name, viewing Revit models in Power BI. You can give it a description as well. I'm going to skip that and click on create. So now our branch, our model is set to the one we have just created. So the second option is selection. So you can either send everything from Revit. Everything includes all the project types, all the families and types, project information, levels, materials, views, and all the 3D elements. And you can expand this and click on this drop-down menu and change your selection. Selection is what you want to send from Revit, right? So we can click on the second option. This one, it only sends whatever you selected in the Revit interface, right? The third option is category. So you can filter a category or multiple categories and only send those. So let's say maybe you're only interested in rooms and also floors. You can click these two and you will only send rooms and floors in this case. Let's click on this drop down menu. The third one is a view, so you can send a specific view as well. For instance, if I were to select this option, it will only send the elements visible in this specific view. You can also send a schedule, which will send a tabular data from Revit, your schedule information. And finally, you can send project information such as the levels, views, and families and types. In this case, I'm going to send everything. And let's click on send. Once I click on send, the Revit connector will convert everything from Revit format into Speckle format. Speckle format is platform neutral, so we can receive the Speckle data in Power BI in a tabular way and work with it and create our analytics out of it. The data is sent. Let's view it online by clicking on this notification. And here is our model from Revit in Speckle. So next we want to receive this data in Power BI, and Power BI connector expects a URL. But the question is, which URL? We have three layers of organization in Speckle. We have the first one, which is the project. The second one is your model. And the third one is your version, a commit, right? So if you paste the commit URL, this one right here, you will see this specific version in Power BI. But if you want to create a link between Revit and Power BI, so if you make any changes in the Revit side in the future and send those to Speckle and expect those to be reflected in the Power BI, then the best practice is, instead of pasting the commit URL, simply paste the model URL. That's what we're going to do. So I'm going to copy the URL and go back to Power BI. So if you installed the Power BI connector, it should show up under the data dialog. Simply search for Speckle. So we have two options. The first one is an experimental receive operation that we are trying. But in this video, we're going to go with the second one, which is what we recommend for beginners and more production work. So let's select the second option and click on connect. Once you do that, next step is simply pasting the URL and click on OK. And Power BI connector received the data from Speckle. So let's click on load. Great, we are ready. So our query is right here containing some columns. So let me quickly give you an intro on what those columns are. So when you receive data from Speckle, we auto-generate 5 columns. So those are the commit object ID, Speckle type, stream URL, and URL type. Actually, we can view that in the Power Query Editor better. So I'm going to open the Power Query Editor and move this up so we can see it here. So yeah, these 5 columns are auto-generated by the Power BI connector, and the actual data resides in the data column. So if I expand one of the records, for instance, I can see the info about the object here, right? It's ID, the type, the family, category, parameters, so on and so forth, right? So what are these other 5 columns? The first one is the stream URL, which is extracted from the URL you pasted. That is required for viewing your model in 3D. The second one is the URL type we pasted. So in this case, we've pasted a model, a branch URL, so we can see this and confirm that it's correct. The third one is commit object ID, the version we sent from Revit, and its ID is listed here. As you can see, all rows have the same ID because they are part of the same version. This one, the object ID, is the ID of individual elements in Speckle. So this one is, for instance, an element type. We have a Revit instance, Revit wall. Each has a different and unique ID. So these stream URL, commit object ID, and object ID columns are required to view your models in 3D. So the last one is the Speckle type of the data. We can see that we have some geometrical representation here. We can see this one is a Revit instance, there's a Revit wall, a Revit column, a network element, so on and so forth. So we can, if we wanted to, we can quickly filter out what we want. Okay, so let's go back to Power BI and view our models now. So if you install the 3D Viewer Visual, you will see this icon right here. Simply click on that to add it to the canvas. I'm going to make this full screen. Let's actually collapse the filters. Here we are. So while the viewer visual is actively selected, we can check the inputs it's asking for. So we see it is asking for a stream URL, a commit object ID, color by, and tooltip data inputs. The first 3 are mandatory to view your models. The color by inputs allow you to color your models by any parameter you defined. And I've already recorded a separate video on how to use it. And tooltip data shows a tooltip about the selected object in the viewer. There is also a separate video on this. Okay, let's drag and drop the columns to the relevant inputs, stream URL, commit object ID, and object ID. So once you do that, the viewer visual will start fetching the data from Speckle and view your model in 3D. Okay, perfect. Now we can see our Revit model inside Power BI. So if you remember, I talked about copying the model link instead of the version links so we create this live link between Revit and Power BI. Let's confirm if that's the case. Because one thing I realized is the color of topography is not the same as the Revit's color. In Revit, it is green. In Speckle, it is gray. Let's check the reason of that. So I'm going to select the topography element. And I can see that it doesn't have any material applied. That's why. So by default, if it doesn't have any material applied, it'll show up as green in Speckle. So we're going to change this by assigning a grass material. So I'm going to search for grass. Select those elements. Maybe let's make the green a bit lighter. And click on OK. So now we have changed the material of topography. Let's send it to Speckle again and see if the changes we have sent are reflected in Power BI site. Okay, it is sent. So now let's go back to Power BI and simply refresh our connection. And this will fetch the new version since we have created the relation on the model level. It will get the new version and update the corresponding rows, and which will also get reflected in the 3D Viewer visual. Okay. Here we go. Yes, as you can see, the color of topography is now green, which confirms that the link between Revit and Power BI is working. So that's it. If you have any questions, just let me know in the comment section below or in Speckle's forum, speckle.community. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.